Americans have been debating the role of government in health care insurance for nearly a century, ever since Theodore Roosevelt, as candidate of the Progressive Party in 1912, proposed that the government act as insurer of last resort for Americans for health care. The idea became central to the Democratic Party's agenda, beginning with the New Deal, when President Roosevelt, Franklin Roosevelt, and then President Truman both pushed for what we would now call a single-payer health care system. That idea has remained in the Democratic platform right down until 2008. Actually, in 2008, it was removed, although the idea of government assuring universal health care remained within the Democratic platform. The major achievements in health care reform are mainly those of Lyndon Johnson and George W. Bush. Lyndon Johnson, first of all, with Medicare and Medicaid in 1965, and then President Bush with a major extension of Medicare through Part D, the prescription drug coverage, during his administration. In other words, Republican presidents have gotten into the act too, beginning with President Nixon, who was the first to indicate that he would support a single, not a single-payer system, but a public option on top of our existing system of private health care, similar to what President Obama is now calling for. President Reagan also called for the extension of Medicare as a catastrophic health care plan for Americans under age 65 who are not covered by private health plans as well. So the House Resolution 3200, which the media usually refers to as the President's plan, actually draws upon not only Democratic but Republican ideas of the past by calling for the establishment of a government-supported exchange through which the uninsured can find low-cost insurance or, in the last instance, through a public option, which under the legislation might actually be administered by a private insurance company in practice. How will Americans address this issue and where will we go? Obviously, it's enormously controversial. Many Americans remain very uncomfortable with government taking on any role, but I think it's a given that government will have a role and must have a role. We have two problems. We have the problem of the uninsured and we have the problem of high costs. And that really pulls us in two directions, because to cover the uninsured obviously is going to cost more money, and we're already paying too much. Indeed, when we compare ourselves to other nations that are in our neighborhood, so to speak, in political and economic systems, we're paying on average twice what they are, but we're not getting better coverage for it. We're not living longer, we're not living healthier lives than, say, the French, the Swiss, the Norwegians, the Japanese, the Canadians, or any other highly industrialized, affluent nations such as ourselves, advanced democratic society. Where we're going with health care remains to be seen. I think it's a given that Americans don't want government running the whole thing, and yet I think it's also a given that government must be involved and will be involved. I would humbly suggest that we look at what other nations are doing, nations that are spending a lot less than we are on health care and getting results that are just as good, if not better. In my political commentaries, I've been trying to draw on a historical perspective as well as a comparative perspective. I'd love to hear questions from you. If you have any questions, please feel free to post them and I'll answer them as best I can.